Today we're going to be building a mechanical grabber. I hope you guys are ready to grab onto some science. Step one, grab the slider and put it into the lever. Then grab the lever lock and install that on the other end of the slider. Make sure the long parts are pointing in the same direction. Next, grab this arm piece. Make sure the arrow is pointing over here. Then we're going to take a long green bolt and put it up through the hole in the very middle. Next, we're going to put on a yellow washer. Go ahead and rotate your lever lock down here so it sits like that. And it's a little tricky, but make sure you're following along. Put the lever hole on the green bolts, and then we're going to put the peg on the slider into this slot. It should work just like this. Then on top of the lever, we're going to put another yellow washer. And then find this big grip piece and put it in just like this. Those little pegs will fit right in. Then grab the other arm piece and sandwich it on top. Make sure the pegs from the grip are sticking up through the holes as well as the green bolt and the slider. Perfect. Now let's secure it all into place with the green nut. Then flip it up on its side and install a blue joint on the end, right above the gripper. You'll know it's installed correctly when that little hole is all lined up. Then slide in a long blue bolt. Secure into place with a green nut. All right, time to make a big handle sandwich. Stick up two green bolts and put this little bar piece on top. Then we're gonna slide a wood handle piece and then the foam. Then another wood handle piece. And lastly, put another long bar on top. Secure everything down with two green nuts. Make sure all your nuts are screwed down nice and tight. Then we're going to line up these two holes in the handle with the other end of the arm pieces. And then secure it into place with two long green bolts and two green nuts. Again, make sure to screw these down nice and tight. Now let's assemble the pincher. The light blue joint has two threaded screw holes in the bottom, so we're going to line that up on the wood pincher base. Attach it with two short green bolts. Next, we're going to add the pincher holders. You'll notice that one side of the clip is a little bit thinner, so make sure that goes in the thinner side of the hole. And then the other one will be mirrored. Perfect. Should look just like this. Double check that your pincher holders are pushed in all the way. It should be sitting nice and flush against the base. Next, to attach the pinchers. You'll notice there's a little notch here and a little peg here, so we just gotta push these together really tight. This step needs quite a bit of muscle, so don't be afraid to ask a grown-up for help. All right, nice. Your pinchers are all the way in. Time to add some grip. You'll notice in the back of this little suction cup piece that there's a little ridge. We're gonna slide that into the notch on the other end of the pinchers. Make sure they're in all the way. Nice. Make sure that they're actually pointing each other so that when you close the pinchers, it actually helps pick stuff up. Next, we're gonna attach these little loops. So if you push out that center tab, you can pull it in like that, slide it down like that. This part's a little tricky, but once you get the hang of it, it makes a lot of sense. Pull in, pull down. Great. All right, now time to lengthen our arms. With the logo facing up, put the square peg in the square hole. And secure it down with a short green bolt. Perfect. Same thing on the other side, square peg, square hole. Using another green bolt to secure it into place. Then you're going to want to slide these arm pieces into the light blue joint. Make sure to push it in all the way until the holes line up. Also double check that they're actually inside the joint and not outside. Now that it's in, let's secure it onto place with a long green bolt and, you guessed it, a small green nut. Then we're going to do the same thing on the other end. Push the arm pieces all the way into that dark blue joint until the holes line up. And same thing, long green bolt, little green nut. We'll keep it all in place. Now let's thread it up. Stick the aglet through the middle of this yellow piece. Then slide it all the way down. This helps lock it into place. Then take the other aglet and put it down through the center. Push it first through the light blue joint. Pull it all the way down the arm. And then stick it through the dark blue joint. It should be sitting just in the middle like there. To finish securing it, you'll need to make sure that your lever is pushed all the way forward. That way you can reach your lever lock. Notch it into the little hole in the lever lock and then give it a test. You should be able to pull that lever all the way back and then push it all the way forward. Make sure that the lever is all the way forward again, and then we're ready to connect the pinchers. Now let's hook these little loops onto the yellow piece. The best way to do this is by bending the pinchers around. And then you do the same thing to the other side. You're gonna curl it in and then be able to slide that loop on. This step shouldn't require a lot of force. So if you're having trouble, make sure that you're pressing in from the center piece or from the very tippy top. All right, now that that's on, go ahead and give your lever a pull. Ta-da! All right, so we finished our grabber. Now for the piece de resistance. Wiggle eyes. You can put these anywhere you want to make your grabber extra silly. I think I'm going to put mine right here. Now that I've added my wiggle eyes, it's time to look at ways to play. All right, now to use it. So you can either grab back here on this handle or up here, whichever one's more comfortable. I like to hold back here. The important thing is that your other hand holds this big red lever to actuate it. The awesome thing about this grabber is that it can grab stuff that's super far away, like stuff that's even off camera. Wow! And if you want to hold stuff indefinitely, you can actually pull this red lever all the way to the back position and it'll lock. To release it, just push that red lever forward and you're ready to grab something else. Side note, make sure that you don't try to pick up things that are super heavy. It'll be really hard and things might slip out the end, which could be dangerous. Time for some troubleshooting. If you notice that your claw is a little bit floppy, Go ahead and make sure that all of your bolts are nice and tight. So just go one by one and tighten all of them down. Doot, 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 doot. Don't forget to check these on the end too. All right, now that's much sturdier. If it's really hard to pull the lever all the way back, then double check that your string isn't wrapped around anything or stuck. And this can sometimes happen if you pick up something too heavy, but if your pincher falls out, just go ahead and pop it back into place. If you need a little bit of extra muscle, don't be afraid to ask a grown-up for help. There's a lot of really cool science and engineering that goes into your grabber. For instance, this big red handle is actually a giant lever that allows you to pull that string back with a lot less input than you get for pull strength here. So if you pull it back just a little bit, you can see that string start to move backwards. You've pulled all the way back, it locks. So what's actually going on in here? Let's see. So here's a mechanical grabber where I've pulled off the sides. So if you check it out, we've got this big red handle, and as we pull it back, you can see this string moves back, and that's what closes the grabber arms. And if we pull it all the way back, chunk, then you can actually see that it locks itself into place, and that's how it's working. Whoa! So something you may not realize is that you're kind of an expert at picking things up. That's because your fingers have a nice frictiony surface to help you grab onto stuff. Check this out. So this big heavy Erlenmeyer flask, even if I just use my tips of my fingers, I can still pick it up. Pretty cool, right? But what would happen if my fingers were all slippery on the end? Let's find out. Probably something like this. Not very good at picking up. That's why when we made our own mechanical grabber, we added these flexible rubber tips on the end to act just like fingertips. Check it out. Wow. Science is pretty cool. So, you've probably heard of robotics, but have you heard of soft robotics? It's literally robotics that are like squishy. Pretty cool, right? Well, it's really, really important when it comes to how robots operate and pick things up especially. If you think about how you pick things up in your everyday life, you're probably not walking around going like this to open doors or pick up a glass of milk. That would be disastrous. So when we designed our mechanical grabber, we knew we wanted to use soft robotics. These big flexible fingers on the end allow us to wrap around the object we're picking up and use a really gradual increase of force to be able to pick up a lot more objects and a lot more strongly. And that's soft robotics. Thanks so much for building along with us today. If you had a good time and you want more easy to follow builds just like this, make sure to subscribe to our channel. Thanks. To release the box, pull forward. And we're gonna definitely do another take. That's why when we made our own biomimetic grabber, that's the wrong crate. Right here, really quick. See if that helps me see what I'm grabbing better. No, that's not very effective. Okay, I'm gonna try it on. I would not recommend that.